Adding a complex feature to an existing application can be a nightmare. It often requires changing multiple source files. How do we add a feature without jeopardizing all other features that are already working correctly? Incremental coding is the way. That must be your second nature. In this video, I will teach you a coding technique where we add code in smallest increments possible. We will never affect any existing feature in the application, but in the end, we will still be able to enhance an application with a brand new feature it never had. This is the demo application which is lacking a complex feature. This page is displaying books, and books have authors, but the missing feature is that each author here should be a link to the books of that author. We don't have that feature right now. And here in the book details page, each cell in this see also section is just a link to the details of another book. I also want this cell to be split into multiple elements. I also want each author to be a separate link to the books of that author, and the title maybe to be the link to the book's details. I will just show you the finished application before we implement this feature. This is what I want to have, every author being a link. If we follow the link, we will have the books of that author. If we click on the title, we will have the details of that book. And here, every author is also a link, and the title is the link to the book's details. So this is what I want to have in the end. But how do we do that? There's a ton of code in this application already. How will I implement this feature? Well, that is where we start doing things incrementally, in very, very small steps. This will be a coding tutorial. I will show you every single line of code I change, and you will get the grasp of this wonderful technique and powerful technique that is letting you develop even the most complex features in so small steps that you will never be in danger of introducing a bug to an existing application. This is the root of all the problems. This is the formatter, which is turning a domain model book into a what? String. String doesn't have structure. String cannot tell us what part of it is the author and what is the ID of that author and what part is a book's title, for example. So the first step, the first increment, is to substitute this string with a proper class. Now, that step alone is very complicated, and there is the entire video on doing this operation precisely, substituting this string in this interface with a proper domain class. So watch that video. It is dedicated to removing primitive types from the application. It is dedicated to removing primitive obsession from the domain model. This domain model, this interface, is obsessed with a primitive type, a string. And that is the root of all the problems we are having here. That is why we don't have that wonderful feature in the application. I will repeat the exercise from that video above very quickly, because this time I want to put stress on incremental coding, that is the coding that is never jeopardizing any other feature in the application. We could break the application here and do everything in one go, but the risk of doing things that way in this particular domain model is that we might introduce bugs. I want to move in small steps to avoid making bugs. So the first step is to augment the string and turn it into a proper domain class. That will give us a place to put domain logic later. But forget the domain logic. We just want to wrap a string and to let this class behave like a string, so to not disturb anything that already works in the application. I will make a string assignable to the citation and also make the citation assignable to the string. So anything else in this application that used to work with strings instead of this citation class will keep working the same as before. A very small step, do you see? Now comes the next step, making this model do more than what a string can do. We want to cut the citation into segments so that every segment can potentially become a link in the UI which the user can click. The citation would consist of many segments. This is what strings could not do. The caller could instantiate an empty citation, or append a new segment to the end, or append the entire citation, why not? You see, we have the whole new class which can be used as the string, and it is being used as the string in all the rest of the application, unfortunately. But it can also be used in a richer way, in a better way which string cannot follow. We are at the brink of introducing a brand new feature and a brand new ability into this application. Still, we need to keep that illusion of working with strings. I will re-implement both methods, but retain their public interface so that the application will keep working as before. Nothing has been changed in the external look of the application. Nobody will ever see that we did something under the hood. But we did. We did. We are ready for the next improvement. There are different kinds of segments. Not every segment is the same. One will be an author, the other will be a book title, and yet another will be a plain text in between of them, for example, to separate them. Again, I'm making a change, which is actually not a change. I will turn the base segment abstract, so there will be no just segments. Everyone will have to say what kind of a segment it is. And I will introduce one kind of them, plain text. What used to be just a segment will now become a plain text segment. But what is the consequence of this change? Looking from the outside, nothing. Nobody, not even the immediate caller of this cast operator, can tell that something has changed. Nobody can see the change, but the change is there, privately encapsulated. We have added an ability to segment the segments, to make segments different from each other. A new ability, which we are now going to turn into a new feature. I'm defining other kinds of segments. One is the author. The author has the name, but also the identity, the author ID GUID, so that we can construct an anchor tag in the HTML, for example, out of an object of this class. And the last one, book title, also attaching the book's ID, so wherever you see a book's title and you need to render it in the UI, you can also make an anchor tag which leads to that book's details. Those are the features we didn't have in the application. Now we are creating an ability to implement that feature. By the way, this system of types is simulating a discriminated union in C#. C# doesn't support discriminated unions yet, but for a disciplined use of records, you can reap all the benefits from discriminated unions in other, primarily functional languages. You can watch the video on discriminated unions as well. I have made a video on this exact example, but again from a different angle, viewing the problem as the modeling problem and using discriminated unions to model these segments. You can watch that video and enjoy taking a different look at C#. Now comes the pinnacle of this demonstration. We are totally ready to implement that missing feature because all the abilities that were missing are now here. Before that, I must ask you to like this video. If you have stayed so far, you must be liking it already. So please press the like button. Thank you. And also, You may be wondering, where is the source code? There is a lot of source code here in the initial and in the final stage of this demo. The source code is available to sponsors of this channel. So become the sponsor. Follow the link to my Patreon page, which is in the description. Become the sponsor of this channel. Help me maintain this channel and get access to the source code, the initial and the final source code from this demo, and also the source code of all other videos on my channel. Thank you very much. I'm really grateful to all people who have already chosen to become sponsors of this channel. Let's implement the missing feature now. There are two other interfaces that are supporting formatting books. The one is formatting a single author's name. It will also produce a citation now. This is the concrete implementation of that interface. It's just used to return the string. It will have to wrap that string into the author segment this time. Watch this. And that object will also carry the ID of the author that was used to format it, so the information is retained this time. We have the information. We can do anything else downstream when we get the object returned from this formatter. The second supporting interface, the author's list. It will also return the citation, and here is one concrete implementation, academic format. Well, that is really complicated logic. But with citations, all the information is retained. Every single author produced by this formatter will carry its own ID besides the name. Now, this is much better than what we had with the strings. By this point, I have completed or enhanced all producers of citation objects. And this implicit conversion from a string to a citation, I don't need it anymore. I will delete it, and if any piece of code failed to compile, that would be indication that I have missed something. I would have to make a step back and fix that. This stage of development is over, and again, the application will still work the same as it did before. I haven't affected anything in the external view of the application. We can push it to production. We can let the users use it. Nobody will be able to tell that something is different in the application. Oh, but it is different. It's totally different model this time. So we are ready for the very last step, removing the dependency on toString, enhancing the UI to really display what we have prepared here. There are three places where we are rendering citations in the UI. The book recommendation in the book details page, this is one occurrence. And there are two occurrences in the list of books. One is where we are listing the authors, and the other is where we are showing the book's title. In all three places, we are currently calling toString, or the framework is calling toString for us. But now we want to render the citation. How do we do that? The UI will need access to those segments. So let me just expose the segments in form of a sequence of segments. Implementing will be trivial. Just delegate to the immutable list, the private list. And then comes the most beautiful part, completing the UI. Now, since the citation is a complex class, I will even introduce a partial view for that. Why not? Iterate through the segments of a citation and render each one in the best way we can. If it is the book title, then format it as a link to the details of that book. Look, I'm capturing this segment variable into a strongly typed book title segment variable and then accessing the title and the ID from that object. From that reference, it is the same object all the time, to render both the link and the text of that link, which will be the title. This is an entirely customized portion of HTML, which is only possible when there is the book title. Otherwise, if it is the author, I'm repeating the process, but the HTML will be different. The outer segment will be displayed differently. And also these two will be styled differently. There is the CSS file, which is styling book's title and book's authors differently. Otherwise, just render the text. I don't care about this, but there is the style, of course, for plain text. The final step, enhance the UI to utilize this partial view and to render the citation in a different way, in a way other than just calling it to string. That was really primitive. Use the partial view to render the book's authors. I don't care how this will be done. I'm pretty sure it will be done correctly. And render the book's title as a citation. Do the same in the book details. This is that see also table showing recommended books. Every part of the book recommendation will now be rendered appropriately for that segment type. The final touch, remove the toString implementation. I don't even have to have it here. The time has come to show you what the application looks like now. The new feature suddenly becomes visible. We have been implementing this feature for quite some time. The end users could not see that anything is changing until the very last moment when we just switched to using the partial view. And everything fits into place. Out of nowhere, the application has a new look and feel. The entire large feature becomes operational. Every author here is a link. I can follow the link to the book by clicking on its title. The list of recommended books here, each segment is a link. This is the link to the author. This is the link to the book's details. Everything works as expected. We have a new, large, complicated feature added to the application. But remember, every single step was microscopic, safe, and didn't disturb anything else. We always make changes in two steps. The first step is to enhance the abilities of some domain model, and the second step is to modify all the users of that model to start using that ability. And if you do that carefully, you will be climbing up, 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 until you introduce a very complicated feature in the existing application. I hope you liked this demonstration. Don't forget to visit me at Patreon, become the sponsor, and download the source code from this demo there. Thank you for staying till the end, and see you in the next demonstration.